Chapter three is the Mid-South's fathomable past.
The core of the Mid-South, where Lion Lawman Kunpan came from and where he was most at home, is comprised of three provinces of roughly the same size that lie along the eastern side of the Malay Peninsula: Nakhon Si Thammarat, Pathalung, and Songkhla.
We're here at this northern little body of water that's called the Little Lake, Talay Noi, and it is connected to this larger body of water, and there's a channel that runs down to the lagoon here at Songkhla, and the lagoon empties into the Gulf of Thailand. And this is the region that I've called the Mid-South. As late as the 19th century, there was no land here. It was open to the ocean.
Geology and geography conspired to create an environmental niche for the provinces of the Mid-South.
เช่นถ้าเป็นริมทะเลก็จะมีป่าชายเลนพอพื้นที่ราบลุ่มก็จะมีป่าสาคูแบบนั้นนะครับพอบนเขาก็จะมีป่าดิบชื้นแล้วซึ่งตัวสัตว์ตัวต้นไม้อะไรมันก็ต่างกันออกไปอีกแล้วทีนี้เรามาเจาะจงเฉพาะในพื้นที่ทะเลสาบก็ยิ่งมีความหลากหลายเข้าไปอีกเพราะว่าการเป็นทะเลสาบที่มีลักษณะสามน้ำก็คือทางตอนบนสุดของทะเลสาบ
When Kunpan was just beginning his police career, the abundance of food and natural resources supported a very small population, something that is still discussed by local people. At the time the policeman was active in the 1930s, the South was estimated to have only 13% of Thailand's population. Even with the opening of the Southern Rail Line in 1907, the area was wild and underpopulated well into the 20th century.
The policeman was received a kind of initiation ceremony when he began his police career at a cave-like monastery in Pathalung, known as Wat Khao Aw. And this limestone formation was a haven for refugees from the law, fugitives from the law, not refugees, fugitives from the law, and for monks who wanted the solace and privacy of a cave for meditation.
As late as the 1950s, settlers were still moving into the region. Government infrastructure remained weak and banditry was endemic. The budgets of provincial administrations were centralized by the national government, and proxy suzerains like Songkhla and Nakhon Si Thammarat no longer controlled their own finances.
The last part of this chapter deals with the geopolitics of the Mid-South. Nakhon Si Thammarat and Songkhla were both little, you might call them city-states.
The policeman's active career from 1930 to the late 1950s witnessed the arrival of a new sovereignty that rested on territorial control, rather than on the contingent and intermittently unenforceable sovereignty through the tiered tribute system.
The memory of this still plays on the what is written about the Mid-South. It was once very famous. It was once very powerful.